okay, will be pushed into this output, and the remaining records will be pushed into this second pipeline. Okay. So did I tell you one more example of this? Let me see. So execute SQL task. This is not there. Okay. So let me go for another example of conditional split. So in this basic one, what we have done is we have just applied one single condition. Okay. So we have sent some source data. So we have sent some source data in which I have some salary column is there, and we have applied some condition like salary greater than 25,000, and the records which satisfies this condition will be pushed into this, and the records which are not satisfying this condition will be pushed into this different pipeline. That's it. Okay. So now let us try for another condition. Let us say if your customer wants one more pipeline, let us say he wants to see the list of employees who are working from Chennai city, who are working from Chennai city. Okay. So apart from this existing list, he wants to see one more list. Okay. Who are working from Chennai city. Now let us go and see. Did I completed this? I think we are in the.
Yes.
Yes. I think.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
By using multicast, yeah.
By using multicast, all those things we completed. We completed the data convert that derived column also. I think I have opened the wrong solution here. Yeah. So we have completed the derived column also. Okay, now let me go for another one. So let it be SSIS Abhishek only. Okay, so let me go for next one, that is. So we have completed aggregate, conditional split, data conversion, and derived column. Now let me go for lookup. Okay, and before going to the lookup, let me go for OLTP command. Okay, so there is a link between them, not a link. I need to explain this. So let us say I have a text file. My source data is coming in a text file. Let us say this under this desktop merge source files, I have this file. So in this text file, let us say I have some M5 records out there. Okay. Now I want to load this text file data into my SQL table. Then how we can load is, since my data is coming from a flat file source, no, I can go to this. Okay, if I want to load the data, so first of all, let us take a data flow task, double click on it. And since your data is coming from a text to file, let us select the flat file source and let us locate the flat file, create a new connection. Okay, create a new connection. Now let us go for, so let us say this is lookup, no? So let us say OLTP source, OLTP data connection. Okay, now let me locate that file. So in the desktop we have one merge source folder. Under this OLTP data text file is coming, and if you want to preview the data, there are five records. So I want to load this data into the SQL table as destination. Let me take from the destination list, let me take the OLTP destination. Now let me pass this data to here. So into which database? So we have a existing connection for DB Abhishek. Let me take that. Okay. Or if you want to push the data into DB Brook database, then go and create a connection to the database. So, so my server name is Balaji-PC. My SQL server name is Balaji-PC. and in that we have one. So it will show the list of databases. Let me select the DB Group database. Test connection. Click on. Okay. So what is the table name? Let me create a new table to store this information. So this is the list of columns coming from the source, and it is going to create a table with this. Now let us say table underscore. Okay. So let us say EMP data or EMP or OLDB DB output. Okay. So OLDB output, like that I'm creating a table with this. Now go to the mappings. So map your input columns and the destination column. That's it. Okay. So now let us go and execute this. So it will get the data from the text file, and we are loading into the SQL table. That's it. Now let us see whether it will get loaded or not. So we are loading the data into the SQL table. Let us go and cross check our database. So let me connect to the DB underscore group database. Click on new query window. So let us say select star from okay, table underscore LDB output. Okay, we are able to load the data. Now after initial loading, let us say this data, now let us say my customer, what he has done is, so he has done some modifications to the data. So let us say the employee one salary got increased. Let us say he is sending the new modified data. So let us say his salary got improved from 90,000 to 1 lakh. Okay, from 90,000 to 1 lakh. And for the second employee, let us say he got transferred from Hyderabad city to Chennai city. Okay. He got transferred from Hyderabad city to Chennai city. And for the third employee, let us say his, or for the fifth employee, let us say his designation got, he got promoted to manager. So let us say he got promoted to manager. So some changes are happened to the existing data. Some changes are happened to the existing data. Now I need to do the same changes on the SQL side destination table also. How to implement these changes on the already loaded table also? Okay. In order to do that, what you can do is, let me save this file. Okay. Now after initial loading, I need to modify the, based upon the flat file data, I need to modify the existing table data. Then in order to do that, what we can do is, you can drag and drop on data flow task. Okay, if I run this, now let us see. If I execute this again, what it will do, it will go and load it as a new records. I don't want to do that. I want to modify the existing data. Then what we can do is take one more data flow task, and first of all get the latest file, flat file source. Now let me create a connection to the latest file. The file connection is already existing. Yes, the connection is already existing. We can reuse that, and we can go on preview. Now we can see the modified text file is coming. So he got salary, and he got promoted, he got shifted to Chennai city, and the fifth record got promoted to manage. So we are getting the latest data. Okay. Now this changes I need to apply on the destination table, SQL table also. No? Then in this case, go and take the OLDB data, OLDB command transformation. So inside this OLDB command, we can write any DML statements like insert command, update command, and delete command. So now I need to update the existing table data now. Then pass the source data into this, and here go and write a update command here. Now first of all we have to specify the connection. So that table destination table is present in which database? That is DBBrook database. Now specify the connection to that database. Go to the component properties section, second one, and here we have an option to write a SQL command. So we need to modify the destination table data, no? So we can write that update command here. Click on this icon, it will open some window. Now I will write the update command here. So based upon the source data, now I'm getting the latest source data. So based upon the source data, I need to update my destination table also. So what is the table name? Select the table name. So update table. Okay, set. So which are all the columns you updated? So if you know the list of columns you have updated, so we have updated the salary column, no? So you can go and specify update set salary is equal to, I want to update the salary column, and I don't know the values. Okay, we should not hard code. We have to apply this command for all the records, not for one record, no? So I don't know what is the value I need to update, then put question mark, comma. And for the second record, we have updated the city column, no? Okay, we have updated the city column, no? So let us take this as EMP city is equal to question mark. We don't know what is the value we have updated. Okay, after that, we have updated the designation column also, no? So let us write designation is equal to question mark. Okay, and for which employed, where EMPID equal to question mark. Okay, we are writing a general statement here, generic statement. Okay, so update this table set. So we already know which our columns you have updated, that's why I'm giving those columns only. If you don't know, better to specify all the columns. And for which corresponding employee, we have tried this where employee equal to question. Now we are writing the update command here. And after this, go to the third. So we have question marks. Now we have to specify what values we need to pass for these question marks. No? That we can do in this column mapping section. Go to this. Now you can see we have used four question marks. No? So we have four param 0, param 1, 2, 3. And for the first question mark, param 0 means first question mark. So what is the value I want to pass from input data? Now you can see available input columns. So this is the columns coming from the text file. Okay. So in the first question mark, which column you are updating? So in the first question mark, which column you are updating? Salary. Okay. So here in this column mappings, we have to just say, so from the input data, I want to pass the salary column for the first question. Similarly, for the second question mark, which column you are updating? So city, designation, and employee. Okay, city, designation, and employee. So just go and specify the order. So second question mark, I need to pass in the second question mark, I need to pass city value. In the third question mark, I need to pass designation value. In the fourth question mark, I need to pass employee value. That's it. Okay, so we can write the command here, update command here, and we are writing a generic statement. Okay, and we are passing the values. Okay, we are passing the values from this column mapping section. That's it. Okay, so now we are getting the latest data, latest changes. Okay. Whatever the changes we are there, no? We are getting the latest changes, and with that latest changes, we are updating the existing destination table by using this OLTP command. So now we can see before that, now for employee one, it is in the destination table, it is 90,000. And after executing this, let me go and execute this. So now we can see. So all the five records are passed into this command, and this update command will execute for all the five records one by one. Now you can go and see in your destination table. So the changes are applied or not, you can see affected or not. Now you can see it is affected. Employee to Chennai and employee five manager is designation is changed to manager like this. Okay. So this is how we can modify the or update the existing destination table. Okay, now one more thing is, now let us say my customer, what he has done is, so along with the for existing employees, let us say some more changes happen. Now let us say for second employee also, his salary got increased from 50,000 to 60,000, and third employee he got shifted to from Chennai to Hyderabad. Okay, Chennai to Hyderabad. Okay, and along with this existing column, existing employee changes, let us say, so he is sending the new employee list also. Let us say some new employees joined the company. So along with the existing records, so he is sending the new employee list also. Let us say employee 6. Now let us say employee something like Ravi. Okay, something like Krishna, like this. Okay, so some 70,000, okay, some 80,000, okay, some city, let us say Hyderabad. So along with the existing record modification, so he is sending the new list also, Delhi city, like this. Okay, now let us see what how we can load this. So for if it is any changes in the existing data, we can go and apply the OLDB command. Now for how we can identify the newly inserted records. Okay, how we can identify the newly inserted records. Okay, so now let me save it. Now if I go and execute this command, what will happen? So it will do the changes only for new record, only for existing records. So now you can see if I re-execute this, so all the seven records are passed into this, but you can go and see whether the new records are inserted. No. Okay, so it has gone and updated the existing ones. Okay, senior software engineer from 50,000 to 1 lakh, from EMP city from Chennai to Hyderabad, like this. But is this new records got inserted into the destination table? Now you can see 6 and 5, let us say 6 and 7. So these new records are not inserted. Then how to insert these new records into the destination table? How it means we can use this. Let us go and see. In this case, okay, we can use this lookup. Okay, in this case, we can use this lookup. What that lookup will do is, let us show you. So this is for OLDB command. Okay, now let us go for one more data flow task. So let us go for flat file source. Now in this source, what will happen, what is happening? So the existing records got modified, okay, and along with that some new records are also coming. So we have 6 and 7 as the new records. Now let us take his salary got updated to 0. Okay, like this. So let me save this. I'm doing some other modification also, and I'm inserting some new records also. Okay, now let us go and locate this. Is the connection is already existing? Yes, connection is already existing. Now preview. So now we can see we are getting the new records and salary got updated to 0. We are getting both the records. So my requirement is, so if the record is already existing, I need to go and update. Okay, if the record is not existed in the destination table, I need to apply the insert command there. Okay, I need to apply the insert command. For already existing record, update command. For a new record, okay, I need to apply the insert command. So first of all, I need to compare this source data with the destination table data. I need to compare this source data with the existing SQL table data. And after comparison, okay, I need to separate the existing records and the new records. Okay, that's it. How we can do that is, so this is the source data. Now to do that, we can take the help of lookup. So inside this lookup, what we can do is, so we'll pass the source data, okay, and open the lookup. And here we can see, so generally let us take, so your destination table is present in a OLDB connection, means your destination table is present in a SQL table, no? Then select the connection type as OLDB connection and go to the second option, connection option, and here you can specify, okay, your destination table is present in which database. Let us select DB Brook, and in which table you are inserting the, with which table you want to compare. So my table name is table underscore OLDB output, and you want to preview the data. You can see we are previewing the data. So now what we are doing is we are comparing our source data. So this is my source data, and we will go and compare with the destination table data. Okay, if the record is already existing, okay, here also one is there, so here also one is there, and here also one is there. Okay, means for the existing records we need to apply the update command. Okay, so we have created the connection to the destination table. And for comparison purpose, okay, so now you can see this is the columns coming from the input text file, okay, and this is the columns coming from the destination database table. Okay, for comparison purpose, so for comparing these two sources, what is the mapping column you can use? So we can use employee column. So here also employee is there, here also employee column is there. So for mapping purpose, okay, for comparison purpose, I can take these two, employee ID and employee. So using this employee ID column, I want to compare this by source data and the destination data. So we have selected the comparison column. That's it. Now go back to the general section. And here you can see we have an option called specify how to handle rows with no matching entries. No matching entry means, so in the source data we have employee ID 1 is there, and in the destination table also we have employee ID 1 is here, that is matched. Okay, employee ID 1 is matched. Okay, and in the source data we have 1 2 3 4 5 is there, here also we have 2 3 4 5, these are all matched records. Now in the source data there is 6 and 7 is there, there is 6 is there, but in your destination table is there any 6 is there? No, that is a new record, means there is no matching, so no matching entry. Okay, so for that 6 and 7 there is no matched records, so it is asking for a specify how to handle rows with no matching entries. Okay, if there is no match between your source data and destination table data, how you want to handle? Do you want to fail the component? No, I don't want to fail the task. Do you want to ignore the failure? No, I don't want to ignore also. Okay, I don't want to fail and I don't want to ignore. Do you want to redirect rows to no match output? Yes. So it will give me two outputs. This lookup, what it will do is, like conditional split, Okay, so this lookup also will compare the source data and the destination table data. If a record is matched, it will push them into matched output. If the record is not matched, it will put them in the no match output. Okay, so it will give you two outputs, two pipelines. One is matched, another one is no matched. Or do you want to redirect them to error output? No, I don't want to push them in the error detail, error output. Then select this option. Redirect rows to no match output. Okay, that's it. So what this lookup will do is we'll compare the source data and the destination table data, and it will separate the records. Okay, it will separate the record, our records, into matched output and no match output. The existing records will be pushed into matched output. The new records will be pushed into the new match output. Okay, now we can go and see. So let me, for the existing records, what I want to do is, okay, for the existing records, you can see here match output and no match output. So the existing records I want to put into the match output. Okay, and here I can go and write the update command. Here I can go and write the update command. So your table is present in which database, and what is the command you want to write? Let us go for update. Okay, which table data? Table underscore OLEDB output. So the same command I'm writing here. Okay, set salary is equal to question mark. Okay, comma. EMP city is equal to question mark. Comma. Designation is equal to question mark. Okay, where EMP ID is equal to question mark for the corresponding employee ID. After writing the update command, I can go to this column mappings. Is there any syntax error is there? So update table name, set salary equal to question mark, EMP city is equal to question mark, comma, designation.
Designation. Equal. Spelling.
Okay, designation. Designation is equal to question mark, where employee ID is equal to. Okay, now you can see we are getting the four params. Now let me pass first question mark salary value column from the input, second question mark EMP city, third question mark designation, and fourth question mark EMP ID. Okay, that's it. Now this is for existing records update command. Okay, update command. Okay, for existing records. Okay, now this pipeline is giving me the existing records. Now for the new records, so it is giving us one more pipeline. Now for the new records, I can go and write the insert command here. Okay, insert command. So in this OLEDB command, now you can see lookup no match output means for the no matching records, I can go and write the insert command here. So how many columns this table has? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 columns, no? So we can go and write the insert command here. So now I am writing the insert command. Insert into table underscore OLEDB output values. So we have eight records, no? Eight columns, no? Right? Eight question marks. Question mark, question mark, comma, question mark. Let me copy this. Okay. Like this, okay? Insert into table name values, eight question marks. And go to the column mapping section. Now we can map in order. Employee ID. Employee name, date of join, salary, EMP city, branch ID, gender, and designation. Okay, so this is the list of columns, no? ID, name, data of child salary. So I'm mapping in the same order here. That's it. Okay, so this is for new records. So new records insertion. Okay, so the matched records will be coming into this. Now here, how many matched records? 5 matching records and 2 new records. No, so now let us go and execute this. So the lookup will compare the source data and the destination table data, and it will separate the matching records and the no matching records, and it will put into 2 pipelines. That's it. So this we will call it as incremental load. This is also called as incremental load concept. So now we can see 5 records are pushed into the match output and 2 new records are pushed into this no match output, and we are applying the insertion command there. So now we can go and see. You can see for the existing records it is updating, and we can see new records are also inserted in the destination table. Okay, so now, so this is called as incremental load. We are able to identify existing data modifications, and we are able to identify the new records also. Okay, like this. Now let us say one more thing. So let us say some 2 new employees are joined. So let us say some more employees are joined. So let us say employee 8 and employee 9. Okay, and let us say some changes are happened. Let us say salary is increased from 0 to 20,000. Okay, so some other changes, let us say technically to something like program manager. Okay, like this. Now we have inserted 2 new records. Then some changes to the existing records. Let me save it. Now here, if I go to this, here now you can see. So instead of applying the OLDB command for inserting the new records, what we can do is, let me take a lookup one. Now let me take a copy of this. I don't want to disturb the existing one. Let me paste it. So let me give it as lookup 2. So instead of you going and writing this insert command, okay, so the easiest way is you can remove this. Anyhow, you want to insert the data into the destination table, no? Then you just select OLDB destination here. So what it will do, if you want to push the data from flat file source to OLDB destination, we are directly putting that one. No? So here also for the new records, you no need to write the insert command manually. We can directly push them into the destination. And inside this destination, we can just select your table name. So this is for already existing table. No? So you can just select the table name here. Table underscore OLDB output, go to the mappings, map your input columns and destination. That's it. Okay, for inserting the new records, okay, you don't need to write insert command again. You can then just take the, you can just push the data into the destination, or you can take the help of OLDB, you can take the help of OLDB destination. That's it. So now we can go and see. Now we can see the existing records are pushed into this update command, okay, and new records are pushed into this OLDB destination. So now we can go and see Can see 8 and 9 also are inserted, and his salary is raised from 0 to 20,000, and his second record got updated to program manager. Okay, so like this also we can do that. Instead of writing the OLDB command for insertion, we can just put them in the destination. Okay, like this. Understood? Any doubts?
Yes, so the table that you were working on, there was this unique ID, employee ID, right?
Yes.
What if that kind of column is not there?
Then how we can compare? So
yes, what if there is no unique identifier in the table? How would we?
So there should be, means at the time we don't need to apply this concept at all, no? So it is, you can just load the data. So there should be some comparison.
Okay, otherwise this is not possible.
So otherwise you need to create an extra column like row number. So in order for creating the comparison, at least we have to create one extra column to compare each records separately. So if you want to compare the two sources data, there should be some comparison, no? So
yes,
either you have to go for some row number concept, okay, like a, what we'll call that, like a surrogate key. Okay, so
so we can also create a combination of multiple columns to check, right?
If it is there somehow.
Okay.
Yeah, if you want to compare multiple columns, so we can go on here, select those. You can see if you want to compare, join not only one column, we can compare.
Okay,
now
okay.
It will compare on multiple columns like this.
Okay, okay.
But at least some comparison should be there.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Okay, understood. So one more task is, now in this source data, we are able to identify the newly inserted records and existing data modification. Now suppose some employee got removed. Now let us say my manager or my company has abandoned or fired one employee. Okay, now let us say employee 4 got deleted from the source data. Now I need to delete it from the destination table also, no? I need to delete it from the destination table also. Then how we can identify the deleted data? If using lookup, we can identify the newly inserted records and existing records. Then how we can identify the deleted record? Can you try that one today? Okay. So that will be called as full incremental load. Okay. So we are able to identify the existing and do the update, and if it is a new record, we are able to identify and do the insert. And if a record is deleted from the source, I need to delete it from the destination also. Then how we can identify the deleted record? Okay, so please try that today. If you are not able to do that, we will explain in the tomorrow class.
Okay.
So that will be called as full incremental load. Just try that. Okay. After that, tomorrow class I will explain. Okay. So by using the merge join, we can get that. So instead of lookup, we can go for the merge join. So inside this, you can see we have one more thing called merge join is there. So using that, we can achieve that full incremental load. So in tomorrow class I will explain that. Okay. Thank you guys. So and Shamik and Martha, so if you want to re-listen the SQL classes, no? So I have started a new batch at morning 5:30. Okay. So Martha, if you want to re-listen the SQL classes, we can attend that batch also, no problem. No need to
Okay,
pay, no need to
thank
pay
you.
any extra things, okay? Just leave.
Yeah, but I won't be able to make it at 5:30, but still thank you for the offer. I have another class
Oh,
in
okay.
here.
Oh, okay. No problem. Yeah, just want to make sure.
Thank you, still thank you so much. I'll attend whenever I can.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. No
Thank you.
problem.
Thank you.